complete for the sake of life eternal, for the sake of heaven, and for the sake of bringing thousands and millions into the kingdom and bringing the people into the kingdom, that you'll be able to stand the way Christ wants us to stand, and the kind of church he envisioned, and the kind of church that he dreamt about, and the kind of church he sacrificed for, that this church will be that kind of church, holy and pure, without blemish and without any wrinkle. You want to tell the Lord, I'll be part of such an army, I'll be part of such consecrated people, I'll be such a kind, I'll be part of such a disciples that will make this church what it ought to be. Tell the Lord, tell the Lord, tell the Lord. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. This is the greatest prayer you can ever pray. This is the highest prayer you can ever pray, that everything once again will come to the way it was in the New Testament, and they give up everything. Nothing was precious to them. They give up everything so that they will be the kind of men, the kind of women, the kind of disciples, and the kind of servants of the Lord they ought to be. We ourselves ought to consecrate afresh, and we leaders and ministers and pastors to consecrate afresh, and we members of the church and workers, we need to consecrate afresh, that Lord, this is how I'm going to stand. I'm going to stand upon the word. I'm not going to be playing a religion. We're not going to be playing or joking with superficial religion. We're going to stand upon the word of God until the end of our life. Consecration every day, cross bearing every day, self-denial every day, and we're going to have that holiness without which no man shall see the Lord for the rest of our lives. One day at a time, one day at a time, one day at a time. There'll be no day of self-indulgence. There'll be no day of self-will. There'll be no day of rejecting the word of the Lord. Every day consecrated to the Lord. Every day consecrated to holiness and righteousness for the rest of our lives. And then when the trumpet shall sound and the dead in Christ shall rise, then those of us who are still alive will be caught up together with them to meet the Lord in there, because we have lived righteous and holy and purified, and we have lived rapturable, translatable lives. That's what the Lord wants to do. Be part of the army of God, part of the saints of God. When the saints go marching in, that will be part of us. You'll be part of us. And then you'll bring many people into the kingdom while you're still over here in a day of opportunity and day of duty and day of responsibility, that God will help you to be part of the army of the Lord, bringing other people to know the Lord and to know his salvation, to know his sanctification, and to know the power of the Holy Ghost in our lives, in their lives.